I believe if you're a Sixers fan, you're waking up this morning and you feel great about your general manager. You feel great about your team. Daryl Morey comes in, leaves the Rockets after 13 years, and he already has made his presence felt running the Sixers. Morey recognized he had two superstars that aren't great shooters in Ben Simmons and Joel Embiid, but they're great players. So how can we maximize the talent that Daryl Morey has on his roster? Well, yeah, get rid of the Al Horford contract, which was an abysmal signing last year. We said it at the time. And a year in, the Sixers at least have acknowledged it was an awful move. Al Horford, age 34, last year signed a $109 million contract for 4 years. They trade him and a pick to get Danny Green. Danny Green, two-time NBA champ. Danny Green now has been traded twice in the last week, but he goes to the Sixers where he could provide spacing and shooting. Then they follow that move up, and Morey sends Josh Richardson and a pick to the Dallas Mavericks for Seth Curry. Seth Curry, if you didn't watch a ton of Seth Curry last year, shot a career-best 45% from three-point range. Seth Curry is perfect for the style of basketball the Sixers can now play by opening up the floor by trading away Josh Richardson and obviously trading away Al Horford. And the very funny dynamic now, as I mentioned in the short open to begin our show, is Curry's father-in-law is the head coach of the Sixers, Doc Rivers. Point being, Daryl Morey, I believe, made two solid trades, and the Sixers got a lot better last night